show is called Yap Live on Nonsense. My name is Tumosime. I'm always here weekdays from 8 to 8:30 p.m. So make it a date. This is another year. I want to thank everybody that has been watching this show for as I don't know, man. We've been here for a while now. Stay here. So I want to thank. I don't take anything for granted. It is hard, man. Stay here. It's very hard, man. How these boys work on these other TVs? They be just talking to themselves, man. Go home and ask their mothers, "Did you watch me?" It's like, man, you man, I watch you, no. Like no one even, but yo, you watch, man. And I appreciate that so much. So, if I went for the break, was he talking about President Museveni, who decided to treat his cows to a meet and greet party, and he brought Amama Mbabazi, he brought Kanda Bongo Man. So, Kanda Bongo Man is there, you know, looking at cows. Cows are waiting for a show, performance. Wow. Museveni wabivako, man. So, up to now, I keep on wondering, why was Kanda Bongo Man at a farm? What? This man is old. He has... Like, what did you think he was going to do, man? There are many places that we can take Kanda Bongo Man to, man. Stay here. Hey, Kanda Bongo Man, this man entertained people who were, you know, those people who had the chance to live before HIV came. And sometimes I wonder how that was, man. Like, can you believe that? Like, when you were saying those in the morning, can you believe going to club? Pick a girl. You're not worried of HIV. If I was born in that time, I would have died of prostitution, man. Well, this day, that's the thing that really scares us, man. Abortion you can remove, man. Check it out. You know? But there was no HIV, man. People just used to have some money, like you wake up with, like, you know, you have itching, just breathe like salt and warm water. Clear up, man. Just be with a woman, you wake up, you always scratch yourself like this, bro. Yeah. So Kanda Bongo Man came in Uganda and he was at Sizozi Farm. I think Museveni was trying to talk him about agriculture is the future, because Museveni, for some reason, is obsessed with agriculture, man. He thinks that every person in Uganda should be a farmer. I think this man just wants to rule us as if he's an alien or an overlord. Every person in Uganda is supposed to dig. Hey, join agriculture. You join agriculture. Wealth creation. And people who keep on telling us to join agriculture, like my boss, they have a lot of acres of land. Some of us are renting, man. What? You have to choose, man. You know, if you plant like one banana on the veranda, on the backside of the house, you put like one cassava tree, you know, then you have to wait for those to harvest. Then you put now oranges, man. Come on, bro. You know, agriculture is not for a poor man. You know, I saw someone who was saying that you can practice agriculture by putting like they design like some suspending, like a garden. You get like basins, then you tie them on a tree, you hang them with ropes, then you plant. It's okay. How much are you going to get? You're going to get like 4 carrots. If you're harvesting them, if you're like a woman harvesting them, men, for some reason men like eating raw carrots. I've never known why. A man steals off one. Now you have like 3. Go to the shop. Chameleon. Chameleon was a tenkuka. Yeah, that's Chameleon right there. No one is a chameleon, man. Stick here. Singing like Bobby Wine. Trying to act like Bobby Wine. And the reason he did this is clout. Let me first say that word again. Because I know some of you are old and you don't know what these things mean for young people. Clout. Clout literally means I'm a serpent, like Obutara, right? Goes to perform and sing songs of Bobby Wine. Dressed in a Bobby Wine shirt, because he identified an opportunity. He noticed that the biggest star at that concert was going to be Bobby Wine. No one wanted to see anybody else. So they arrested Bobby Wine. And this Mahanja man, I will give him credit for that. He thought to himself, he's like, people want to see Bobby Wine. They don't want to see me. People want to see Bobby Wine coming and telling them, this government or President Museveni is not working for lawman. Come sing for them, Nubian. Then he first goes backstage to sign the money. Then he gives Nubian 5K for transport. Yeah, Nubian is the one who sustained the show. Man. So Camilo noticed that no one wants to see anybody else. If Camilo had come out, people are just ready to see Bobby Wine saying, what's the name of that song? Bikwase Chagulanyi. Bikwase Chagulanyi. And then when people are ready to see that, then you come. I'm a H. Pepe over Jamila and Aliyah. You like, you go and Jamila and Aliyah in your wife's house, man. So the man noticed that the star they need is Bobby Wine. And he's like, what if I come out as Bobby Wine? He got a t-shirt of Bobby Wine. He got a hat of Bobby Wine. He sang a song of Bobby Wine. If it was possible to do like a facial paint and he looks like Bobby Wine, he would have put a facial paint of Bobby Wine. And then he comes and then people are like, oh my God, Chameleon Ochikwaze, thank you for fighting the NRM. Chameleon doesn't care about NRM. He left NRM because they shortchanged him. They wanted to reduce the money they are paying him for concerts. Those are the rumors that I hear, but you know, the 100 rumors. But of course, it has to have been over money. Kamion comes out, he's singing Tobonga Nawe, Sevo, Sevo. He's in NRM. Then he runs out of NRM, he's in DP. Then he runs out of DP, he's independent. Now he runs out and he takes a family out of the country. Now he's here. This boy is more confused than a peacock when you ask it, what color are you? Yeah, can you believe if I ask a peacock, I say, what color are you? Peacock say, okay. I'm pink, blue, yellow, magenta, cyan. I can't do this. And it will give up and go back to its house. That's how Chameleon is. He doesn't know what he is, bruh. Bimwagia. Those are the people you support. Hey, our person, our my anja 2021, what is she? Nemuwagira. Yet a man like me who has potential, I am here. I am coming to write. Okay. I don't know if I can ever be a politician because politics is, man, I just think that politics involves you being dishonest to a very, very shaming extent. I don't mind being dishonest in a way. I've ever told women that I love them just to get the private part. But, like, you can't do it every day, every single day. Jesus Christ, come on, man. That's insane. You can't lie today that you... Like, politics involves you being a liar every second. And what's funny is that you're taking people sometimes are led to their death, protecting what they think you believe in. They get arrested, they get women lose kids over miscarriage. You smell tear gas and the kid comes out and you're wondering, the mother of fresh daddy couldn't go to a place that has tear gas and smells it and the thing comes out. You had to produce him. So, but what can you do? I think people will just keep on making mistakes until they get it right. Finally, before I leave this place, every Uganda, every Ugandan is to earn 3.5 million starting this year. That's what Museveni told us in January 2019. Let me first check my bank account. M7, you're a liar, man. There's nothing. So where is our man? So Ugandans, man, this is confusing. Somebody says that by 2020, we should all start earning 3.7 million a month at the least, right? So when you divide that by 12 months, that's mtwala satu. That's not little money. 300,000 can sustain you if you don't want to sleep like with Shila Gashumba. If you want to sleep with Shila Gashumba, you might want to have a little bit more. But 300,000 can sustain you. Also, if you have 200,000 and you make a woman pregnant, the best thing to do is to tell her to kill the baby. And you know the best way to kill a woman to abort? Do not tell her that you're not ready to be a father. You tell a woman that you're not ready to be a father, she will keep the child. You tell her in our family we produce disabled people, or we produce blind men, or we die of cancer. You tell her some scary stuff. She'll be like, but, and you know, you have to use reverse psychology. So let me teach you the principles of abortion, because me, I've gotten a lot of girls to abort. So, do not tell a woman, oh my God, I'm not ready, I don't have money. She will think you're just scared. And her friends will tell her, my man, the first time he made me pregnant, he fainted. But now he's taking care of us and he has bought me a car. So she will think you're going through an episode. But you just come and say, I want that baby. You cannot abort. Please do not abort. That's the first day. Second day, do not abort. I need this baby. Third day, do not abort. Then the fourth day you come, you're like, by the way, at home we produce disabled people who are albinos. Okay, now that's wrong. Because it's like I'm still typing out a group of people. I feel bad. But it's a joke, man. I don't have any other joke. You know, oh, okay. Uh-huh. Let's leave the people with disabilities, and because now that's not fair. You tell her that we produce witch doctors. She will come and tell you, man, you know, I was overthinking. The period finally came. Why are we even talking about abortion? So every Uganda at every point. Now, I want to read a statistic from UBOS. It's the next slide. Producer, put it up. And you see why I'm confused. Cut producer, I ever said. But there's something I wanted to read. It's there. Overall, the average monthly cash income for Ugandans in 2016-2017 was 416,000. That was 2016-2017. The average cash income for Ugandans was that. The average monthly income in urban areas, Ngabola, Kampala, 703,000. More than twice the average monthly income in rural areas was Mtwara Satu. In rural areas, that's the average, 300,000. Kampala had the highest average monthly income of 938,000. That was the average. Of course, they're not talking about you. It's just that they have to get Wavamuno or Vitature who earns billions of money. Then they also get you who earns 100 shillings per 4 weeks. Then they make an average. So, Muribavu, but it's okay. But that's the average, right? Followed by Central, that is Masaka and all that, at 569,000. Bukedi sub-region is the poorest with an average income of 141 per month. But in Bukedi, how much is rent? Those guys, you find rent is like 5K. And then when a guy defaults for a year, say, what? You've defaulted them to for 10 months and you're saying, I'm not saying that, I know that for a fact. So irrespective of the background characteristics, the average nominal income of 2016-2017 was generally higher compared to 2012-2013. Says Uganda Bureau of Statistics. This is not mine. This is not me saying that. This is you, boss. Where we get the statistics from. So who's fooling who? People are rich. No, that's awkward, right? Because if you say that on average, every guy is going to be earning him 200 satu. But people, it's like they're already earning it. So what are you talking about? Oh, God, man. So now I'm confused. Is you boss lying to us? Because they're telling us that we are rich, yet we're not rich. You know? Sounds awkward. That's like a confusing thing. Like, has someone ever looked at you in the ass and tells you, you love me, I know it. Yet you don't. So now what do you do? You know? Or it's like at the time I was passing Gaza Land. You know Gaza Land downtown? And a woman pulled me to do dreadlocks. She said, you want to do dreadlocks? I said, really? She said, no. She said, you want? Now I got confused. I'm like, maybe I want to. So this is weird. So which is the true information? We shall wait. But anyway, the truth is, in a capitalistic economy, you can never say that everyone can earn a particular salary. That's silly. That's Museveni campaigning. You people now, once in a while, slap yourselves and think. It's a capitalistic economy. Capitalism means that the economy is being run by people that own wealth, not the government. When you say that everyone has to earn a particular amount of money, that means that's socialism. But it's a capitalistic economy. So people can never say that everyone earns the same money. You're going to make everybody that rich. It's insane. Even if you go to America right now, it's a capitalistic economy, it's a rich country. There are people who have not earned and they're staying with their parents and their parents' health insurance because that's capitalism. That should be your first lesson of 2020. That's what it's called, Yup, Rebel Nonsense. My name is Dumasive. Shout out to everybody that always watches the show. Weekdays, 8:30 p.m. Until tomorrow, have a very lovely evening. And also, I wish you a very prosperous 2020.